one is that the person suffering from the infectious severe disease can serve as the source of our infection spread to the other disease. If it is affected by the HIV, if it is affected by the AIDS, so some infected disease and some severe infections that can spread from one person to another person. Without, then you cannot treat it very properly, okay? So this leads to the multiplication of above difficulties. It's because of the such reasons that prevention of the disease is better than the cure. But how can you prevent disease? So some limitation is also there. You cannot cure yourself immediately, but you can cure yourself in after some time. Definitely you will be cured and it will take some time, okay? How could you cure? That first one, there is two process. One is general, another one is the specific. General means you can prevent yourself from the exposure. You can see that in the situation of the COVID-19, when you stay at your home, you can see. When you go outside of your home, you come in contact with some infectious person, that will be spread from one person to another person because you expose yourself. So stop exposing yourself, first one. And second one, specific means some disease you can identify and treat them properly, give them the proper medicine. Specific causes you know that and you can treat them properly, okay? So the prevention of the disease occurs by the two types. First one is the general and second one is the specific. If that is airborne disease occurs, how could you prevent yourself? You stop exposing yourself. You stay safe and you avoid the overcrowding region where the infectious persons are present, okay? If it is waterborne disease, you first try to drink the water by any type of antimicrobial agents or any type of medicine. That is giardia is also one of that. You can use with the water for killing the microbial bacteria. And another one, obviously, is safe drinking water. And the third one is it is vector borne disease. You start to clean your surroundings environment, okay? So it can prevent the spreading of the disease. So three ways you can specific and generate. Hello everyone, can you hear me clearly? Hello? Can you hear me? Okay, thank you, sweet. So, there is some limitation. You cannot prevent your disease because if you first one, if you are suffering from a severe disease, your body system will totally get damaged. Now you cannot prevent yourself. Second one, if you some disease take time to be cured, some treatment also takes some time. If you are suffering from a big disease, severe disease, your immune system will also get damaged and your treatment does not work properly due to your illness, okay? And third one, if you attack by the severe infectious disease, that spread from one person to another person. So three reasons are there you cannot cure properly. That first one, if you your body system will get damaged. Second one, if you suffering from a severe disease for long time, the treatment will take time. And third one, if you affected by the infectious disease, that spread from one person to another person. But it is possible to cure your disease. How it is possible? There is two ways you can cure yourself. First one general, second one specific. What is general? General means you can prevent yourself from exposing. If you've seen the COVID-19 situation, when you stay at your home, you can prevent yourself from the spreading the disease. But when you go to the expose, when you come in contact with the affected person, that spread from one person to another person. So stop exposing. Exposing will get outside of your home, okay? And second one, specific. Specific means you know that the cause of the disease, you can treat it properly. If there is airborne disease, you stop yourself just coming outside of your comfort zone or your home, okay? So when you come in contact with the overcrowding region, you can obviously will be affected. But if you stay, avoid the overcrowding region, fungus and dust tissue that related to the environment, there are some other general principles to prevent infectious disease. To appreciate those principles, let us ask a question we have not looked at so far. Normally, we are faced with infections every day. If someone is suffering from a cold and cough in the class, it is likely that the children sitting around will be exposed to the infection. But all of them do not actually suffer from the disease. Why not? Because the immune system of our body is normally fighting off the microbes. We have the cells that specialize in skin infection. You know that cold fever, small foxes, different types of disease occur, infectious disease that spread from one person to another person. But all of us getting infected by this disease. Why? Because that depends on the immune system of your body. If you take the proper food, if you take the proper medicine, and if you lead a healthy lifestyle, you will never be affected by any type of, you get easily affected. Maybe you can be affected obviously, but you cannot get easily affected by this type of disease because your body has the immune system. They can fight against this type of disease. But some of the people you have seen, they are getting so many times because their immune system is not properly worked. Maybe they are present in unhealthy environment. They are suffering from malnutrition. There is not proper nutrition they have been taken. Okay, so this is the cause of the effect of the disease. So this is because the immune system of our body is normally fighting off microbes. We have cells that specialized in killing infecting microbes. These cells go into action each time infecting microbes enter the body. If they are successful, we do not actually come down with this disease. The immune cells manage to kill off infections long before it assumes major proportions. As you note earlier, if the number of the infected microbes are controlled, the manifestation of disease will be minor. In other words, becoming exposed to infected, the infectious microbe does not necessarily mean developing noticeable disease, okay? So, when your body gets the immune system properly, there is some specialized cell. You know that the WBC, that is the lymphocyte, monocyte, they are specialized for the fight against different types of the microbes. When any type of microbes enter inside your body, they totally get fast. You may suffer from this type of disease. Because it is a foreign antigen, it is a foreign microbes, it is unknown to your body. But when your body is known that this is the disease and they already have fight against that disease, they know the immune, what is the immune system of disease, they can prevent yourself. So that's why when smallpox or any type of disease once occurs in your body, there is the less chance affected by the same type of disease. Because your body already has developed this type of immune system. So when these microbes enter in your body, they know that what is the medicines of that disease, they start to get the described this type of microorganisms. So one way of looking severe at infectious disease is that it represents a lack of success of immune system. The functioning of the body will not be good if proper and sufficient nourishment and food is not available. The second basic principle of prevention of infectious disease is the availability of proper and sufficient food everywhere. So you, ma'am, your voice is coming. So when you are affected by this type of disease, your body already had developed the immune system. And if you take the proper nutrition and the water, obviously your body will develop the proper immune system and it is able to fight against the different type of disease. These are general ways to preventing infections. What are the specific ways? The related system that fights off microbial infection. It example to try and understand this properly. These days there is no smallpox anywhere in the world. But as recently as 100 years ago, smallpox epidemics were not at all uncommon. In such epidemic, people used to be very afraid of coming near someone suffering from this disease, since they were afraid of catching up disease. Obviously, there was on those days the medical science was not developed. So that's why when smallpox occurred, so many pupils died. Okay? So the pupils generally getting afraid of that disease because when they come in contact of this type of diseases, they will be chance to that they will be died. So they avoid this pupil. But nowadays the medical science is developed and types of parcels. But when the vaccines will be discovered, that already have discovered, but when that you will get the proper treatment, and if they see that, yes, obviously the people getting rid of this disease, or they are cured very fast, they also start to getting about this type of disease and spreading this type of disease. However, there is one group of people who do not have this fear. These people with smallpox, there is a group of people who had with a lot of scaring. In other words, if you have smallpox one, there is no chance of suffering from it again. So having this disease once means preventing subsequent attacks of the same disease. So all times it is not the scaring that we have affected by a serious type of disease, so we can get, we can die, or we can anything harmful things happen to your body. Never. If you affected by a serious type of disease, your body starts to develop the immune system against this disease. So there is a less chance you affected by the, there is the, yes, so if it is gone, there is the less chance. Maybe you will be affected, but the very less chance, because your body already developed this type of immune system in your body. So that's why there is a less chance when smallpox once occurs in your body develops the immune system against that body. So again, when the viruses or bacteria enter inside your body know that what is the medicine of that disease. So they start to fight against this type of disease. This happens because when the immune system first sees that infectious microbes, it responds against it and then remember it microbes. It close relatives enter your body, the immune system responds with ever greater vigor. The eliminates of the infection even more quickly than the first time around, and this is the basis of the principle of the immunization. So that is the fundamental principle of the immunization, that when your body knows that what is the cause of that disease, or your body already affected by this disease, they start to develop an immune system. So when the same disease, same microbes enter into your body have the immune system already developed, and they start to fight against this disease, and from and compared to the first one, you will be get very soon. Okay, immunization. Traditional Indian and Chinese medicinal systems sometimes deliberately rub the skin crust from smallpox victims into the skin of the healthy people, thus hope to induce a mild from smallpox that would create resistance against this disease. Okay, so obviously when smallpox one time occurs in your body, you have the resistance against this disease. Famously, 2 centuries ago, an English physician named Edward Jenner released that milkmaids who had cowpox do not catch smallpox even during the epidemic. Cowpox is very mild disease. Jenner tried deliberately giving cowpox to the people doing it and found in their now resistance to smallpox. This was because the smallpox virus is closely related to the cowpox virus. Cow is a vacca in the Latin, and cowpox is the vaccinia. From these roots, the word vaccination is comes in our use. Actually, the Edward Jenner, who was the discoverer of the vaccines of the smallpox, he observed that the cowpox that occurs in the milk producing animals, milkmaid animals, the cowpox is just same like the smallpox. So vaccines means the dead organisms inside your body to develop the immune system. Okay, so the Edward Jenner takes the viruses of the cowpox and enters in the human body, they start to develop the immune system or resistance against the smallpox. This is the vaccines of the smallpox. Okay, when we now see that as general principle, we can pull the immune system into the developing a memory of particular infection by putting something, the mimics of microbes we want to actually cause the disease, but would prevent any subsequent exposure to infecting microbes by turning into actual disease. Many such vaccines are now available for preventing a whole range of infectious diseases and provide a disease-specific means prevention. So many vaccines are there, and vaccines means there is a smaller dead organisms are present that infect your body. So when you are affected by the disease, previous that your body already have developed that immune system. So that's why they have the ability to fight against this type of disease. Of course, such a program can be useful only such health manners are available to the children. Can you think of reason why this should be so? Some hepatitis virus which cause jaundice are transmitted through the water. There is a vaccine for one of them, hepatitis A, in the market. But the majority of children in many parts of India are already immune to hepatitis by a time they are 5 years old. This is because they are exposed to virus through the water under the circumstances. Okay? So not only all time you need a vaccine. You have taken so many microbes you have taken through your water, through your food, that also get inside your body. So your body already developed an immune system before vaccine it. So the some hepatitis organisms, the jaundice when occurs, because some jaundice viruses are already present in your drinking water. So most of the Indian children, they develop the immune system against jaundice at the age of 5 years old. They drink water from anywhere. So some disease also enters inside your body. If their immune system is good, that disease get inside your body and develop the immune system against this type of disease. So they do not need any type of vaccination, okay? So we have completed that chapter. Go through this chapter. If you have any question, ask me in your student prompt. Thank you very much for everything. Stay safe in your home, okay? Thank you so much. Thank you so much, everyone.